So I mounted a vintage film lens on my Sony body and wow, the results were amazing. What's up guys? So recently I was watching a lot of Mark Bone and he talks about how he uses a $10 lens on like a $10,000 camera or so. He's shooting with the Sony FX body. Now this inspired me to go out and finally get some of the vintage glass that I already own mounted on my camera, and it was much easier than I expected. Now it just so happened that a friend of mine had just started up his business of building furniture in Mexico, and I pitched a little video for him that could help his business out. I headed out there with my new vintage glass and the adapter that I found on Amazon. These are very, very cheap, like I mentioned. This is what we created. Now all of the B-roll for this video was filmed with the Canon 50mm 1.8 FD mount, and that is a film vintage lens. Even though we filmed this on my Sony a7 III, it still created a much softer look and something that looks quite close to film. And I was very, very surprised because this is something that Mark Bone talks about it, is that the digital cameras create kind of a digitized look, and these vintage film lenses kind of soften that out to make it look and feel more raw, more like film. And I can only say that that is very, very true, because the tones, the feeling, the sharpness, everything from these B-roll shots just looks so much better than what it would have looked with a normal digital lens for my digital body. About a week after filming this video, I thought it would be a great idea to go out and make some photos with this lens, but my photos completely sucked. A lot of them were out of focus. I'm so used to the autofocus on my body, and with this vintage lens, you have to manual focus everything. So maybe I was shooting too wide open. I might try it again. But here's some of the shots that I kind of like, just so you guys can get an idea of the look from this lens. Now, like I mentioned, the adapter for the FD mount, which is the Canon vintage film lenses, is only $15 on Amazon. So if you want to buy the lens and buy the adapter, you're looking at about $60 to $70 that you're going to spend. And I personally think that is a steal for the aperture that you can get with these lenses, the look that you can get with these. I'm definitely gonna look into getting more glass like this. As of now, I have that Canon lens, and I also have a Minolta lens as well that I had purchased a long time ago at a thrift store. For a moment, I was just going to thrift stores and buying all the film lenses and film cameras that I could find. I don't know why, I thought it was cool. Thankfully, one of them worked out, right? So this definitely makes it a more affordable way to get into filmmaking and getting that softer look if you guys are looking for that, instead of going over to those expensive glasses that are digital and then maybe getting a ProMist to soften the look a little bit more and maybe some more post-production. Right out of the body with this film lens, I think it gives a pretty cool look. You can find these lenses on eBay and at thrift stores if you're lucky, because people are buying a lot of the film stuff now and it's kind of really hard to get your hands on it. You have to be going really early and checking all of your local thrift stores, and hopefully you're able to find this. Now, I kind of mentioned this lens that I also got. I'm telling you, I kind of got into this whole vintage film lens for a bit, but I haven't had the chance to open it. I want to make an unboxing, and it is actually an Indus-Star. I believe that's the name. It's like a Soviet lens. It's a Leica mount. I'll definitely be filming something with this and showing you guys what it looks like. Definitely let me know if you guys like this type of content. I've been trying to add more filmmaking stuff to this channel, make it a photography and filmmaking. Let me know if you guys want to learn more and what you would like to learn related to this subject. All right guys, thank you for watching. Stay tuned, like and comment, subscribe. See you on the next one.